Deveria.
Alhamdulillah. فهو تعالى قد أقام الحجة على الناس بما بين لهم من أضرار المعاصي لكي لا يذل ولا يشقى في الدنيا والآخرة. فقال سبحانه وتعالى: تلك آيات الله نتلوها عليك بالحق وما الله يريد ظلما للعالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن الحبيب محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، فقد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، آمين. أما بعد، أيها الناس، عنوان خطبة الجمعة لهذا اليوم بيان شيء من عقوبات المعاصي العاجلة والآجلة، فاتقوا الله واعلموا أن للمعاصي آثارا سيئة على العباد والبلاد، فما في الدنيا ولا في الآخرة شر إلا بسبب المعاصي. فنسيان لرب العالمين أخرج أبوينا آدم وحواء من دار السرور إلى دار الأحزان، وإن تابا فاجتباهما ربهما. وبسبب النسيان طرد إبليس من الجنة، ولكنه استكبر فأخرج من ملكوت السماء فصار شيطانا لعينا، وما استطاع ذريته إلى اليوم إلا أن يسترقوا السمع من السماء فيرمون بشهاب ثاقب. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا. The praise of commendation is due to Almighty Allah, for He the Almighty has established His evidence against people with what He has made clear to them of the disadvantages, the harms, and the evils of sins, so that they will not err in their worldly life, and so that they will not become unhappy in this life and in the life to come. The Almighty has therefore said in Al Imran, Quran chapter 3, in verse 108, verse 108, I quote, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، تلك آيات الله، those are the words communicated by Allah. Not luha alaik. We recite it, we read it to you, bil haqqi, in truth. It has come in truth. Whatever Almighty Allah said is the pure truth. وَمَا اللَّهُ يُرِيدُ ظُلْمًا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah never desires injustice against people. Almighty Allah is never unjust against the universe. I testify that there is no day exactly what he received your mighty law, for you have no partner. I also testify that our beloved Prophet Muhammad is servant of Allah and his messenger. He has indeed delivered the message, fulfilled the trust, and counseled very sincerely this ummah. May Almighty Allah bestow much of His benediction and peace upon him, his household, and the companions of the prayer. Ameen. sermon is to tell us that the sins committed by people will always bring about immediate punishment or delayed punishment, sooner or later. Therefore, I call on you people to fear and let Allah and to know that sins are having very bad and negative effects on people and the country whole. There will not exist any evil either here in the world or such that shall be before some people in the hereafter, except that such will be based on sins perpetrated by people. We are to remember well that it was disobedience to the Lord of the universe that has made our first parent, Adam, our exit from the home of happiness to this worldly abode of different griefs. Even though when Adam and his wife repent, or Allah accepted their repentance, and he embraced them, caressed them. But we should remember also that it was disobedience to the law of Allah that banished Iblis and dismissed him from Agenda. But in his own case, he displayed arrogance towards his creator. And so he was driven out from the kingdom of the heaven. And till this day, his children are not able to penetrate into the skies, except that they always make effort to steal the discourse among the angels in the skies. They are stealing hearing from above, but from time to time they have been thrown with flaming stars that burn them. So, O servants of Allah, you all read the Quran Kareem, and you find there that Allah informed you that sins had made so many countries perish, as Al-Metallah tells us in Surah Al-Nahl, Quran chapter 16. In verse 112, I quote, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا, Allah set forth a parable.
قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً.
Parable of a country home that was safe and secure.
يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا مِنْ يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ.
A country home of some people that which means of subsistence used to come to eat in abundance from every quarter. And make our life to shower his mercies upon them.
فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ.
But unfortunately for them, they were ungrateful to the favors of the mental bestowed upon them. the utmost degree of hunger and fears. Bima kanu yes now, because of what they used to do, because of the atrocities they were committing. Notwithstanding the fact that Almighty Allah has cautioned us in so many verses, He warned us in different ways in His book, such as when He tells us in Surah Al-Shura, Quran chapter 42, in verse 30, I quote, وَمَا أَصَوْبَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ. You should let it be known very well that whatever mishap that may befall you, فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ, it will be based on what you have committed with your own hands. وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ, what should have been befalling you would have been greater than that. But Almighty Allah does pardon many of your faults. You know, in Surah Al-Fatih, Quran chapter 35 in verse 45, and that said here, what do you ask of Allah who has a deep understanding of matter of Allah that they have been done? You allow to see people with the atrocities they are bent on committing that the world, He would not have feared any of them. He asked. All this one is not understanding. The calamities that do before them, such as earthquakes, volcanoes, floods, cyclones, fires, and even deadly diseases and fatal epidemics in many parts of the world. People have continued to analyze such by saying that they are mere phenomena that are natural to occur. They say this, why among human beings there are those who said that Jesus died for their sin. He died for their sin, and they say that death is the punishment of sin. From the bad consequence of people before us, such as the Sodomites, whose city were turned upside down, and they were followed with stones, the creed to perish them from above. Also, what else will people have to say about Qarun? One of the three people of Prophet Musa, who was swallowed by the heart together with his treasures because of sins. That is, sin is always the reason behind every evil before the world. And just of recent, someone in Egypt discovered the treasures of Qarun, and he now appealed to the president of that country, President Al-Sisi, that after digging all the treasures, they should give him 10%. He's asking for 10% of the treasures of Qarun. And if the man is to be given 10%, you know how many trillions that won't be run into the dollars. Not even in He was swallowed by the heart together with all his treasures. Because of sin. And if we have to go on mentioning examples, time will go. But in the little we mentioned, there are signs for those who want to examine their situations to know that calamities come to the world based on atrocities committed by people. So I call on you, my brothers and my sisters, that those immediate punishments that come with all its effects that are visible in incidents that are so terrible, they are as a result of the spread of different kinds of sins among people. You can recall what we tell people now is in HIV, Ebola, hepatitis, and so on and so forth. All these are based on the sins committed by people. But people are not looking back again. Almighty Allah says in Surah 2, Quran chapter 30, in verse 41, I quote, "Zahara al-fasadu fil barri wal bahri." Corruption has appeared on the land and sea. Bima kasabat aydinas, on account of what people have committed of sins. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, just to make them taste part of the atrocities they have committed. Not all. Because if they are to be tested, the punishment they deserve, nobody will remain on the earth. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, Adam made them taste part of that which they have done. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ, with expectation of their repentance, so that they can return back to Almighty Allah. In our country today, some unscrupulous leaders of our public relations have been reported to be burning cash. Burning cash, dollars, euros, naira, and so on and so forth, burning them so that they will not be caught. They don't want those things to be caught. They are now putting fire on them to burn them into ashes. What the hell are they performing? People are suffering, and some of us are not caring. Thank God for the policy of the whistleblowing, the incentives the government laid down here have been helping, even though the elites on our public front are not happy, because they forget that when they die, they will account for what they have committed, notwithstanding the fact that they will leave everything for others. Other people will own them, and they are still going to make a hand for it. May Almighty Allah protect us with his pleasure against his heart. The later punishments coming in the heart will be severe and greater than what people witness here in the world. If those who are committing sins to the Lord, we will make Allah enable us to repent. I say this, hoping that the next Allah will forgive us our shortcomings. Let us ask for the forgiveness of Allah, because He is almighty, He is all forgiving, and He is always forgiving.